And the Chariot, I love just in general because it's the epitome of the hero's journey card. It's like, mm-hmm. get ready, buckle up. You know, a lot of times you can't get to where you're going if you're sitting at home. You got to go. You have to. And whether that's having those astral travels or those mental meditational experiences or literally getting and going, the Chariot is really indicating that a lot of your journey and your path in your life has that aspect of adventure and the call to adventure that's part of the hero's journey. You know, one of the things that people ask me all the time is like, you know, it's, you know, spirituality, you know, that has nothing to do with real life. And I'm like, are you kidding me? It's like, tell me about the movies you like. Tell me about the books you like. And, you know, they'll rattle off a few like, oh, I love the Lord of the Rings or Harry Potter. Or, you know, they'll go through some of these. I'm like, do you realize that is the hero's journey, right? It's Star Wars, mm-hmm. like an older version of that. It's that mm-hmm. sense of here you are in your life. You're doing whatever you're doing. And you're hoping, you know, all of a sudden something gets your attention and calls you to a way of life that's totally different than anything you ever thought about before. And a lot of mm-hmm. times people's first reaction is to resist, right? No, I'm good. No, I really don't feel comfortable going to wherever that is. But then, you know, the universe intercedes, and sometimes it's a disaster that forces our hand, or we have helpers that come to give us that little push out of the nest. And then you go on that whole nice adventure and journey. Mm-hmm. And at the end of it, we come back with those gifts to share with other people because of the wisdom, enlightenment, and experiences we had along that journey. And then we kind of like cycle up, and there's probably a next level call to adventure for mm-hmm. another journey. You know, the sequel, book three, you know, whatnot.
You hear a lot of that whenever they start comparing Harry Potter and Star Wars. About how it's just the wands, the new lightsabers, like that's just, and someone always says, well, it's just the hero's journey. It's a format all the time.
Right. And the hero's journey for anyone who doesn't know about it, it's actually the work of Joseph Campbell. And he had noticed a lot of these patterns, and he'd studied psychology, and I think he even studied some of the work of Freud and some of the psychologists beforehand. And it's like, what's part of human nature? And what do we do? So he codified what he had experienced with working with clients and doing a lot of research. And he also studied mythology and what are the stories in ancient mythology. And he codified that into what he called and dubbed the hero's journey. And there's distinct phases of it. I actually did a podcast just on the hero's journey. If someone's really interested, you can look me up on YouTube. Althea Jacob is my name. And you can look up the Hero's Journey episode, and I break down all of the steps and why is it important to know about this? Because it's good to know where are you on your journey, you know, and who's showing up in your life and what roles are you playing in other people's lives in their hero's journey? Are you the trickster? Are you the person that's preventing them from doing things? Or are you the wise helper or healer who's helping them to go along and encouraging them, that kind of cheerleader? Are you the Yoda, you know, that talks in the mysterious voices and drives poor Luke crazy? Like, what are you saying? I don't get this until he finally
talks backwards. I'm Gandalf. I'm Gandalf the Crimson over here.